Hey, what's up, guys? As you can see, we are back in my tiny home bathroom. And technically, my tiny home, as you can remember, is a park model RV. So I'm going to have a lot of things in here that are related to an RV, a tiny home on wheels, as opposed to a tiny home that's actually built in its place, okay? So you want to keep those two things in mind when it comes to a tiny house on wheels and a tiny house that's built on a foundation. And I'm gonna go ahead and roll this intro, and then we're gonna come back and talk some shit.
Hold up.
So last year I made a video about my tiny home bathroom. Then of course there is also the tour that was done on Tiny House Giant Journey. But the one thing that we have not discussed yet is one of the, I'm gonna say, biggest cons that you have to deal with if you wanna live this lifestyle, okay? So we are gonna be talking about black tanks today. Okay, and I'm going to try and make this as comprehensive as I can and get it all together for you. But if not, I can link some other videos down in the description that I think might be even more helpful if you want to dive a little bit deeper. But you can also do your due diligence, go down a rabbit hole if this is something that you need to know more about. Okay, so if you need to know about the kind of shit that is going on in here, then you want to stick around for this video, and you want to stick around all the way to the end, because I have some tips and I also have some things that you might want to consider and some things you may not want to consider. So make sure you stick around to the very end. All right, let's dive into it. First, I'm gonna be showing you in this video what I've done to keep my black tanks clean and, I guess, like, black tank healthy, so to speak. I want to try and give you as much information as I possibly can, but please keep in mind I am not a professional when it comes to RV holding tanks. Over the years of living this lifestyle, I have learned a lot, and I learned a lot of that stuff actually right here on YouTube. So kudos to YouTube for that. Let's give a big shout out to all the education that you can actually learn on YouTube. Now, of course, everybody don't know what the hell they're talking about, and some people are just like, you know, instant pros, you know, gurus and all of this stuff. And I said this a couple videos before, I am not your fucking guru. I am trying to give you the tips and tricks of the things that I've learned over the years of living this lifestyle. This is a tip that I picked up when I went down that black tank rabbit hole when I was considering this lifestyle, and I wanted to know what I could and could not handle, what was going to work for me and not work for me. You know, I'm not super squeamish, and I knew that I was going to have to hook up my own hoses and dump my own tanks, and it is a nasty, dirty job, but somebody's got to do it. So when it comes to a black tank, there's a lot before you pull the lever on your black tank. Make sure you close your gray tank. A lot of people keep their gray tank open just so that it's, you know, always going. And that is because some of what's coming through the black tank, since these pipes join, you don't want anything backing up into your gray tank. Not that it's gonna back all the way up and come into your home, but it can definitely, you know, cause some things to back up into your gray tank. And since your gray tank is always open, it can get a little bit smelly, or, you know, you could have some buildup, some tissue or whatever. So the best thing to do is, before you go to dump your black tank, close your gray tank, okay? Please keep in mind that if you are in the type of tiny that is on a foundation, then this probably won't pertain to you. But if you're in a tiny house on wheels, if you're in an RV, if you're in a park model like I am, it's built more like a home. If you're in a container home, there are going to be a lot of differences, but hopefully you'll be able to learn something from this video. But also, I want you to know there are different types of toilets. Like, my toilet is a gravity flush toilet, but it's not the same as a toilet that you would find in a Sticks and Bricks. You have macerating toilets that grind everything up, and you have composting toilets that require no plumbing. You got portable toilets where, you know, people are literally just like using like kitty litter. And so it can vary a lot. I've had Dometic, gravity fed, comfort height toilets, cause I'm a big girl, and elongated, cause I got a lot of ass and I need my whole ass on the whole toilet. So with that said, let's keep it moving. When it comes to your holding tanks, you have two tanks. Well, you have three. We're talking about waste right now, because you have your freshwater tank, you have your gray tank, and you have your black tank. So I'm gonna be focusing mainly on the black tank, but with the gray tank, just so you know, that is your shower water, your sink water, your, if you have a dishwasher, washing machine, that's pretty much where all of that water is going. It's going into your gray tank. And the only thing that should be going into your black tank is waste and toilet tissue. And we're gonna get into toilet tissue a little bit later. But for now, I just want you to know the difference. You got your water, gray tank, black tank. We're focusing on the black tank. A lot of what you do with your black tank, you're gonna probably use the same exact steps when it comes to your gray tank, except the black tank is a much dirtier job. Inside your black tank, we have sensors. And I am here to tell you that most RVs that are on the road do not have sensors that work. Like, you really have to have one of those high-end, you know, motorhomes that cost hundreds of thousands of dollars, and maybe your black tank sensor will work. I've never seen one that actually works the way that it's supposed to, even after having my tanks cleaned by the professionals, where they go out and they flush everything, they clean out the walls of the tanks and everything. My sensors still never read what they're supposed to read as empty. So I wouldn't take that into consideration, and I wouldn't worry about it too much. You can always tell if your tanks are full because, number one, the water will start backing up. You don't want that. Or if you open the flapper, you can see that the water level is starting to get a little bit high. That means your tank is starting to rise and you want to go out and empty your tanks. So let's go out and empty the tanks, and I can show you how that's done. Okay, here's my black tank. As you can see, the lever is closed. This is my gray tank. I keep that open. I want to go ahead and shut that and make sure that it's really closed tight so there's no contamination. Now I'm going to go ahead and open my black tank. It never opens that easily, so that's really weird. Anyway, you want to get yourself a really good hose. I like this one. And you also want to get a clear elbow. That'll help you see when the water is actually running clear, or the color of the treatment that you may have used. So then I go inside, wash my hands, and I do a rinse of my hoses. The one thing that you have to remember, and please listen closely, always keep water in your tank, okay?
Always keep water in your tank.
When you first purchase your home, your rig, your RV, whatever you want to call it, your tiny, when you first purchase it, if you're dealing with this type of situation where you don't have a tank and you're not flushing, I don't want to have to keep saying that, but I don't want people like coming for me in the comments like, I ain't got that kind of toilet. Listen, I already said this is going to be based off of my knowledge of what I have lived with, and I'll give you a little bit of information that may spill over into some other situations, but for my situation, you want to make sure that you are keeping water in your black tank. You want to avoid the infamous poop pyramid. Okay, let's talk about the poop pyramid. So when you put things into your black tank, it all just falls right down and it stays in one spot. So what's gonna happen if things just keep dropping into it? It's going to start to create a pyramid where you got it falling on top of it, falling on top of it, in between tissue and some urine. And so they say that you're supposed to have about 10% water. I put about 2 gallons of water minimum into my tank after I flush my black tank. I always keep water in there because anything that's going to go into my tank, I want to make sure that it's gonna like spread out and float, you know? I don't want anything just starting to build up and build up and build up, thus creating a poop pyramid. So you want to make sure that you keep water in there. Try to put minimum 10% of whatever your tank is of water, fresh water, in there. The easiest way to do this is to fill up a bucket. I keep a bucket that I'm able to fill up via my shower, and then I pour the water into the toilet. I let it go down, and this is where I will probably put one of my cleaner tablets in there. And the tablets are also used for eating away at things that could be sitting along the edges of your tank, and we'll get into that as well. But I wanted to focus on just why you need to keep water in your tank. So even after you have flushed your tank, put some water back in your tank. If you are mobile and you're not like me, I'm stationary, but if you are mobile with your tiny or with your RV, you want to make sure that you have water in there, because then it's like slushing around while you're driving. And I think that that's going to help. So if you do that with one of your cleaner tabs or some Dawn soap, a lot of people like to use that. And it'll slush around and knock things off. You can also put things into your black tank, like your cleaner tabs, not things, your cleaner tabs into your black tank the night before you're gonna flush it, if you can remember, and then that way things start to eat away and then it'll be ready to flush. I like to go back outside, and then that's when I will reopen my gray tank. So if anything got caught on the way down, it'll get washed out. And then I come back inside, and then that's when I schedule to either take a shower or wash the dishes. I usually know when I'm gonna be emptying my tanks, so I plan for it ahead of time. If you don't, just go ahead and fill up the kitchen sink or the bathroom sink, or run the shower with some soapy water. Anything that may have gone down your hose from the black tank that may just be sitting there, if you open up the gray tank and you run the soapy water through that, it'll wash that out as well. Keep in mind with your gray tank, that is your kitchen sink. If you're using greasy, oily stuff, that stuff can build up as well. So it's good to also flush your gray tank, and I do that too. I put a tablet in the kitchen sink, I let it fill up with water, and then I run that through as well. I don't do it as much as I do with my black tank because there's constantly soapy water going down there every day when I take a shower and wash the dishes. So I don't do it all the time. I do it more as a freshener, like just a a quick, you know. You don't have to do it all the time though, not like your black tank. You want to keep your odors down when it comes to your black tank, so you have to constantly maintenance your black tank. If you are like me and you're a solo female, get used to it. Those who are married or have, you know, a hubby or a wife who doesn't mind doing it, then let them take that job and then you don't have to worry about doing it. But if you're solo, it's definitely something that you're gonna have to do. So when I come back inside, I wash my hands. I usually wear gloves, but the wind, Vegas wind, blew my gloves away. I didn't know where they were, so I just went and, you know, used my hands. I'm not too worried about it. I also am not very squeamish. As you can tell, I am a bit of a tomboy, so it's whatever. There are things called tank treatments, water treatments, toilet treatments, whatever you want to call them. Basically, the purpose of these treatments are to break things down within your black tank. There are so many different versions, varieties on the market, but basically they all are doing the same thing. They all have one job, and they all pretty much do their one job. I haven't had any issues with it, and I also have every 6 months or so had professionals come out and actually clean my tanks in hopes that they'll actually get the sensor to work properly. But again, I'm not tripping, and I like doing it, especially here in Vegas. It can get really hot, and you actually have to empty your tanks a lot more frequently than when it's colder outside, because when it's hot, if you can imagine, H-O-T-S-H-I-T-T-L-D-O, there is a lot of hot to do. But it helps to have somebody come out and clean your tanks every few months, if that's the case, if this is your situation. I'm stationary, and so it's a little bit different for me. Yeah, let's talk about toilet tissue. Okay, so when it comes to toilet tissue, you're gonna find there is a huge divide as to whether or not RV toilet tissue actually works and dissolves the way. Hold on. Excuse me. I'm such a pig. But somebody out there would like me, like, that's my kind of girl. Sorry about that. I'm such a pig. There's a huge debate on RV toilet tissue, okay? So on one side, you'll have people say that it doesn't work, it dissolves really slow, and it's not worth the cost because it is slightly more expensive. However, if you're buying like the really, really nice toilet tissue, then it's comparable. Then on the other side, you have those people who say if you use a septic safe 2-ply toilet tissue, that it's gonna be less expensive and it's gonna dissolve faster. Okay, six in one hand, half a dozen in the other. I really don't, straight wow. Six in one hand, half a dozen in the other, and now my neighbor is backing up his truck. It's a f***ing circus around here. Anyway, again, six in one hand, half a dozen in the other, okay? I tend to use RV toilet tissue. I use the Scott's brand RV toilet tissue. It works fine for me. It's soft enough for my buttocks, and I don't have a problem with it. Also, something I want you guys to keep in mind, if you're planning to do this lifestyle in an RV, even some of the tiny homes on wheels, if you're planning to do van life and or camper van or something, you will be surprised when you find out that most people, when going number one, do not flush it down the toilet. Now, there may be some comments. Some people might be like, ooh, that's nasty, it stinks, it got an odor. It doesn't. It does not have an odor. You know what? I'm vegan, so I can tell you mine does not have an odor. But I have gotten used to only flushing my toilet tissue down when necessary. And you know what I mean. And that might be the reason why I have never had any issues with my tanks, because I don't clog them up with tissue. Also, it's just me. So, and my grandson, when my grandson is here, my little nugget, when he's here. But again, you know, I mean, he's a boy. So most of them, when they go number one, they don't even pat pat anyway. You know, they just let it, like, I don't know, soak into their underwear. But I'm not gonna get into all that. I'm not gonna put y'all business out there on the street like that. But I'm just saying, if it's more than one person and you're gonna be traveling and moving around a lot, you're not gonna be able to empty your tanks as often. So I just want you to get in your head that when it comes to number one, chances are you're gonna end up putting that tissue in a trash as opposed to down your tanks, because it's less stuff that your tank is going to have to break down. So I just wanted to put that out there, just let you know. Welcome to my world. I don't really want to get into the whole hefty debate about toilet tissue. So I do what I do, and I feel like I don't have a dog in that fight. I recommend that you have a pair of gloves, because things could break. And you know, anyway, I won't get into that. It is good to have a strong hose. You don't want to buy the cheapest hose out there. You want to have a strong hose. It is also good to have a clear elbow. The clear elbow is a good way for you to see that your tank has stopped draining and there's nothing else coming through that clear elbow. Also, having a stand like I have, this is what they look like, and they gravitate downward. They go from high to low, and then you're gonna run your hose along that so that gravity will pull everything down into the tank below. So that is definitely something that you wanna get. I see people have their hoses on the ground, and I guess that works too, but I prefer having gravity just carry it away. So that's another tool that you wanna have. You always wanna make sure that you keep about 1 or 2 inches of water above your ball valve. That is going to seal it off and keep any odors from trying to come up through there when you're not using the toilet. Obviously, whenever you go to flush, you may or may not smell something. It just depends on where you are, your situation, or whatever. I said, it's a dirty job. If you are already living this lifestyle and you wanna, you know, put some stuff in the comments for other people, because people are reading the comments, I don't claim to know it all. So if you have some suggestions, some other tips that you want to put down in the comments, please go ahead and do so. I really appreciate it. Make sure that when you get to the end of this video, that you go ahead and watch another video, okay? That's how we get this channel going, so. Yeah. All right, guys. That's it. I love you. Bye. Alrighty, guys. It is shout out time. And I got a special shout out for Love 2, who is the co-star who came up with the name Fantasy for the new fan. Fantasy. Get it? And I got a shout out for Alice, Jeep Sahara, Lori McCool, Regina Stokes, and Mystical Misfit. Thank you to all of you guys for leaving your comments and supporting this channel. And like I always say, if you're gonna be on here anyway, let another video play. All right, bye!